Welcome to Birding Basics, Size and Shape. So let's get started on trying to figure out which birds are around you through size and shape. To begin determining the size of a bird, it's helpful to use a comparison you already know. So let's use a bird that can be found almost anywhere in North America, the American robin. This medium-sized songbird is found all over in pop culture, and for good reason. This bird thrives everywhere from the grassy patches in downtown Toronto to the high mountain slopes in Tombstone Territorial Park. For that reason, it's the first bird most people learn to recognize on their own. When using a robin as a benchmark, try to determine if the bird you see is larger or smaller than a robin. As simple as this sounds, this can help narrow down the species significantly. To narrow down the field even further, we can use two more familiar birds on either end of the size scale, the black-capped chickadee and the Canada goose. Everyone knows the Canada goose, whether from having to dodge the prolific poop on a soccer field or finding their nests and goslings in the ponds of Tombstone. This large bird is a symbol of Canada and the changing of seasons. Along with being one of the larger birds you can see, a goose has a very distinct shape. When looking at the shape of a bird, it can be as simple as noticing the longer neck of a swan or goose compared to the short and stocky one of a robin. Other body parts to keep in mind are the bill's shape and length, wings, and the tail. On the smaller end of the bird size spectrum, we find the chickadee. This little bird is found year-round in the park and be seen making the most of the winter food supplies and bird feeders. Their silhouette are easy to pick out with their stubby bill, narrow tail, and plump body. So next time you see a bird you don't know, try and compare it to one you do know. And when in doubt, try and find a robin to boost your confidence.